and that way he could be innocent.
Question is, who's gonna stop him?
I don't think, like most people, Mr. Wintermeyer was all bad. You know, far from it. I think he had probably as much good in him as just about anyone else. But I also think he had demons that he struggled with, right or wrong.
And it seems lately, Dave's demons are winning the battle.
I do not sleep well at all. I'm up most of the night. PTSD from wars. Long time.
People that have PTSD have triggers. And when those triggers happen, it takes them to a different place. And they react on those triggers in a lot of different ways.
My neighbor's dogs were on my property. Spineless weasel.
He would come out when we were down at the chimney and just kind of like stand at the end of the yard and just kind of like glare over at us.
Hun?
I started carrying my pistol outside for fear of being attacked in my own yard.
Oh, he's too weird.
Both Spencer and I were taught and still believe that it is not just your right to carry a gun. It is really your responsibility to protect your family, to protect yourself. You should always carry.
I had my permit for 21 years, and I had never had an occasion to draw a pistol on anybody.
Things get worse when Bonnie's backyard pet is found mutilated.
I was outside one day, and this rabbit is dead, propped up on my chimney. Its neck and front legs had been broken.
Hun, breakfast.
Coming.
I did not tell Bonnie about it right away because I knew, you know, how worrisome that would be to her.
I know I heard reports of vandalism and killing a rabbit and all that stuff. Okay, that's not Dave. Dave doesn't poison animals. Dave doesn't do things to a wild animal. That's not Dave.
This has gone beyond just property. Now this is into animals' lives, torturing. It's just a whole different ballgame. It's an act of terrorism.
I think that Dave was going to kill him.
Wintermeyer and the other neighbor went back and forth.
So what did he say? Jerk's clueless.
Talking about how Spencer was weak, how he had no guts, and how the two of them were essentially closing the walls in on Spencer.
Oh.
Things are so tense for Spencer newcomer and Bonnie Henderson. They're not even able to spend time in their own backyard.
Can I help you?
Like, do you not have anything to do?
I'll snap your neck like a twig.
He just stood there like a statue and stared at us. And it creeped us out enough that we went back in the house.
Come on, let's go inside.
I did not see any way of engaging Dave without things escalating into a violent confrontation.
No matter how much Spencer tries to ignore his neighbor, the provocations keep on coming.
I did not realize how closely they were watching, and they must have saw me leave and waited till I left to come over. I built this wood rack so that it couldn't be tipped over. They came over and busted up the wood rack.
Greg is obviously twisted in some way that he just likes to stir the pot.
Think this will work?
Oh, yeah.
The other neighbor was pure and simple, an enabler. You know, I think he's someone that had no desire to confront Spencer directly, but he enjoyed egging on Wintermeyer, who was a more aggressive personality.
Hey, we should get going. He's gonna be back soon.
All right, let's go.
Nice, nice job.
I've had enough of this.
Hey, you okay?
He was right here. That's so creepy.
Bedroom window is maybe four to six feet from the wood pile.
Get inside.
I was scared.
Spencer decides to take action.
Spencer, come inside.
I called the police. They just said there's nothing we can do about it.
Look, it's too late tonight.
And they pretty much took all of this as a big joke.
You've got to do something now.
Calling the police for Dave just added fuel to the fire. It just made him madder and madder and madder.
Everyone, I think, probably has this vision, right or wrong, that the law supports just about any type of violence as long as it occurs on your property. It was this sort of fundamental understanding of we can physically assault him, you can do anything to him, as long as he's on your property. It's probably a complete misunderstanding of the laws of normal society.
Friday night, Spencer is determined that he and Bonnie spend some quality time at home.
We're just sitting back there, drinking a beer, relaxing, talking about our days.
Little does he know, it makes them an easy target.
Spencer had no idea that these neighbors were texting with each other and egging each other on.
Hey! Keep your friggin' dogs off my property.
He did not know Spencer was sitting on the deck because of the way our chairs were positioned, and he was yelling basically at me.
If they come back here again, I will make you eat their crap.
He was screaming at Bonnie.
I will physically hold your head down and make you eat crap.
That he was gonna come over there and force her to eat dog.
You hear me?
So I'm not a big woman, so for me, he's overbearing, and it's scary.
And if Spencer doesn't like it, you can tell him to come out here right now.
I was experiencing several emotions. One was just incredulous at it, that he's really thinking he's going to come over here and force her to eat dog crap. Not gonna happen. The other part was fear. I mean, this guy is just totally unhinged now. Greg is peeking through his fence, watching the entire episode go on. Monday morning, I'm going into the police department. I'm going above the heads of the officers I spoke to. Okay, this is a serious situation, and I expect action to make this stop.
Find a way.
Greg's not waiting till Monday. He and Dave plan to wake Spencer up Saturday morning with loud music and provoke a final confrontation.
I think their goal was to kill Spencer.
But things don't go as planned.
Spencer's routine was to take the dogs out in the morning before he went anywhere, and I think he was running late. So he walked out the front door.
Hey, Spencer, you got a sec?
I'm late.
Oh, really? Where are you off to?
Corvette show.
It just seemed odd, like he was trying to hold me up.